Welcome to Civil Engineering In. Step 3, driving sheet piles. Now comes the crucial part, installing sheet piles. These steel sheets with interlocking edges are driven deep into the seabed using a vibratory pile driver. But have you noticed something special about this machine? It doesn't just push the sheet piles down, it vibrates them into the soil. This high-frequency vibration reduces friction, allowing the sheets to penetrate deep without damaging them. The piling process starts from the corners and moves toward the center to maintain alignment. Once the sheet piles reach the bedrock, the cofferdam's outer shell is ready. Step 4, strengthening the cofferdam. At this stage, we have a temporary barrier, but it is still weak. The single-layer sheet piles alone cannot withstand the immense water pressure. To reinforce the structure, engineers create a double-layered cofferdam by installing another set of sheet piles parallel to the first layer. The space between these layers is then filled with sand, gravel, or broken rock. This adds stability and prevents water seepage. But is this enough? No, a bracing frame system is installed inside the cofferdam. These horizontal beams, called struts, connect the walls and resist inward collapse due to water pressure. Without these braces, the cofferdam would fail under external forces. Now, we're ready for the next step. Step 5, water pumping and dewatering. With the sheet piles and bracing system in place, it's time to remove the water. High-powered pumps gradually extract water from inside the cofferdam. But suddenly, disaster strikes. Water starts seeping in from beneath the structure. This phenomenon, known as bottom heave, occurs when water pressure forces itself through the soil under the cofferdam. How do engineers solve this? By constructing a concrete seal course. Step 6, building the concrete seal course. The solution is simple but effective. First, workers remove loose soil using clamshell buckets operated by cranes. Then, large hollow steel pipes are driven into the bedrock to anchor the foundation. Using a tremie pipe, specialized high workability concrete is poured underwater. The concrete displaces the water and settles onto the seabed, creating a watertight seal. Once cured, this layer blocks further water seepage, ensuring a dry work site. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to Civil Engineering Ed.